how I lost 120 grand, roughly 120 grand in a very short period of time. That's what I want to talk about in this video, okay? So if you don't know who I am, my name is Arnold G. Sommer, and I've been doing internet marketing for the past, like, maybe 10 years now. And a lot of things happened along the way, okay? It was a journey of success as well as a journey of failure. I experienced a lot over the past years. Anyway, in this video, I want to show you what exactly happened, what I did with the money, how I lost it, and hopefully you can learn from my experience so you're not going to make the same mistake again, or just make the same mistake in general. I know for myself that I am never going to make the same mistake again because I learned a lot from this experience. You know, I got punched in the nose big time. I learned from it. I evolved. But yeah, let's get right into it. But before we do, you know the drill. Help me out, like this video. If you're not part of this community yet, then join below. Click the red subscribe button. Also turn on alerts so you receive notifications whenever I upload a new video. Let's do this. Let's do this, guys. I just got bitten by another mosquito. I really like these evening walks. The only thing I don't like is the mosquitoes, okay? But that's a whole other story. Anyway, let's do this. So what happened? I mean, I got to a point where I got really, really comfortable in my business. And this is something that we as entrepreneurs have to struggle with every now and then. What typically happens is that you set a goal. And in most cases, it's a financial goal. Like whenever you hit this or that target, you think like you're done, because we all get started with an end goal in mind. You know, we want to make money because we want to buy certain things. We want to buy stuff, right? Maybe for you, it's a sports car. For another person, it's a $1 million home. That's what they're striving for. That's why they do what they do online, right? For me, it was always traveling. I always enjoyed integrating in new cultures. I enjoyed the freedom that the internet marketing industry provided. So that's why I got started initially. May not be the same for you, but once I got what I wanted, which was an abundance of money, a lot of things changed. I changed as a person. I remember how different I was. You know, at first I was very modest. I was very much, you know, I didn't really care because I just had a goal, so I hustled like crazy until I finally achieved that goal. But then once I became fat, financially fat, you know, everything changed for me because I was able to buy the stuff that I wanted to buy. And you can guess what happened. Once you got money, once you got a good amount of money, you know, like more than enough that you don't have to worry about your living expenses for the next couple of years. And I got to that point a few times already. You know, you get very, very comfortable financially. And that's a mistake because you always want to feel uncomfortable. You know, you don't want to feel spoiled. You don't want to feel like, you know, I achieved everything, now I can just relax. Because remember, in digital marketing, you have competition. You're not alone. There are a ton of people out there that are competing with you. So you can't really take the foot off the gas pedal. It's not going to end very well. So, yeah, I mean, I squandered my wealth. For instance, let me give an example. I mean, I'm brutally honest with you guys. I mean, I'm not hiding anything from you. I spend $6,000 on a vacation. You know, and I did it several times. You know, I stayed at an overwater bungalow. You know, it's what I wanted to do. And the woman I was with at that time, that's what she wanted. And I gave it to her. But right now I would prefer having that money sitting in my bank account, in my business bank account, or having that money invested in assets would be a lot smarter than what I did. But I did it because it was what got me started in the first place, you know? It was my initial motivation. And you're probably in the same situation right now where you are looking forward to enjoy the things once you have the money to buy them. And it's very natural. You know, success is a cycle. There's a success cycle, you know. First you start with the goal in mind that you just want to make enough to cover your living expenses. And once you get to that point, you want to be a little bit more comfortable. So maybe you need another, whatever, 5 or 10 grand a month. And then once you're at that point, it gets really, really bad, because at that point in time, you're gonna start wasting money if this is your goal, instead of really putting the money to work for your business. And I know so many entrepreneurs that made the same mistake. Endless entrepreneurs made that mistake, because you don't know the game until you played it, right? So it's a learning experience. So what should you do instead, and what did I learn from my mistake? What I learned from my mistake, I know I keep touching my head, and it's because I get bitten left and right by mosquitoes. Just look at this. But what I learned from this whole experience is, yeah, it's very important to have financial goals in life, okay? So I'm not saying that this is wrong. I'm not saying it's wrong for you to make a lot of money in business. In fact, you should, because you need it to be able to afford employees in order to be able to spend money on advertising, right? But you need to value money, okay? Value every dollar that you make. And one thing I can tell you from personal experience, and if you take a look at rich people are oftentimes, especially like movie stars or someone, you know, they're usually the unhappiest people there are, because the only goal they have is to get new stuff. Their whole life's mission is pretty much predicated on superficial stuff. So they want more and more and more in order to feel fulfilled. And that's a vicious cycle. So if you look at the rich person and you're like, wow, this person must be happy because they have the stuff that I want, you don't know what kind of a life they live, because having more stuff creates more responsibility. It takes time away from your business, from your life. So it changes people. Whether you want to admit it or not, whether you see it or not, it changes people, changes everything. That's what I learned. So, you know, I read a quote, and you can take away everything from a skilled person. Would it be money? Would it be assets? Would it be whatever, like a team? Take everything away from someone skilled. Within a year, that person will be back at the same level. He or she will be back at the same level within a year. I can pretty much guarantee you that. They have the same goal that they used to have, and that's what it was for me. So the whole lesson from this story is, once you have accumulated a good amount of money, mark my advice here, okay? Once you have that, do not squander it, because you spend years of momentum in order to get there. If you just take a look at how much time your education cost, how much time you spent. You know, it's not in a week that you made it happen. It took you years of continuous progress, years of your time. So you need to be very, very diligent with your wealth. Be diligent. Now, the mistakes that I made are very unique, and I was at the point, I'm still at the point right now, where I could just take the money that I have, I could buy a house, I could buy a nice house, I could buy a sports car if I wanted to, you know? I could spend 150K on a sports car, no problem, I can do that. But it's not my mission, you know, because I know I'm not going to be fulfilled if I spend that money. It's just never going to be enough, because what else am I going to want? So I think once you have created enough income to cover your living expenses, so you don't have to worry about food, shelter, and you live like just below your means or whatever, you know, depending on what state you live in or what country you're living, you know, you may need a different amount of money to live the kind of life that makes you happy. But once you're at the point, you know, once, for instance, you have like a home you feel comfortable in, you know, where it's quiet, or you have enough money to do extra things, to have a little bit extra. From that point on, you're not gonna get much happier if you spend 5 times more. You know, in fact, usually get unhappier. That's what I learned, okay? That's what I learned, and it was a very painful experience. It took about 2 years of my life to learn this lesson. And like I told you, I lost 6 figures along the way. But what I always think about life is that life is long, you know? Even if you're 50, life is still long. You know, it's not like it's gonna be over tomorrow. You still have plenty of time left, plenty of time left. You don't have to worry about not having enough time to spend money or to do that. No, but set a goal, okay? Be ambitious, be driven, like just aim for the stars and make it happen. And once you're at that point, okay? Once you're at that point, you've got money, you have enough to cover your living expenses, and you feel good about yourself, you know? Once you have enough cash, because you want to be smart about it, because business is all about runs. You know, we can have a good running business, we can have a bad run. You know, we can see that right now with this whole crisis. You know, nothing is guaranteed. You can be out of business tomorrow if things go bad, especially in a digital business. A digital business is very fragile. So you can't just live like there's no tomorrow. You need to preserve capital. Preserve capital. Super important lesson that I want you to take away from this video. Anyway, I think that's all I wanted to cover. Let me know your thoughts. Just post them down below. If you think that I was stupid, it's all right. Just post your thoughts down below. If you have anything to add, if you want to share your personal experience with me, then do the same. Just leave a comment. I'm going to respond to each of you individually. If you haven't done so yet, please help me out. Hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm. In case you're not subscribed yet, this is your chance. Click on the red subscribe button, okay? You're gonna be notified whenever I upload a new video on YouTube. Other than that, guys, thanks for watching, and I see you on the next video.